If you're looking to buy an external SSD for your Mac, then there's a couple things that you need to consider. And in this video, I'm going to help you understand everything to know about SSDs and Mac computers, some of the models I recommend, and which ones I would buy depending on the type of work I was getting it for. I'm going to have links to buy all these drives in the description below. Some of these drives and enclosures have been provided to me for free, but these are the ones that I have tested extensively and use every day to make sure that they're the best possible options for you to buy. The first thing to know is there's two main types of drives. There's pre-built and there's enclosures. So an enclosure is going to come without a drive in it. You're going to have to get your own drive and install it, which is really easy to do. But there's some issues that you can run into with heat buildup and also with certain drives not being compatible or recommended with certain enclosures. So I personally recommend most users just buy a pre-built drive. Then when you look at pre-built drives, there's a couple different speed classes. The first level is the USB 3 speed. So those are drives like the Crucial X9 Pro or the Samsung T7. These are typically going to hit speeds of about 950 megabytes a second, being going to be good for most day-to-day work and still be very fast for most users. You can totally edit photos, videos on them, and do a ton of work with these. But if you're running them with intensive video editing tasks, you will notice they start to bog down a little bit over time. I mostly recommend these for offloading files when you're done with projects, or also if you just need a good solid SSD, but without the top speeds. Just know if you're doing intensive video work, these will start to slow down on you over time. The next class of drives I'm not even going to recommend. It's the USB 3 2x2 drives. And those promise speeds up to 2000 megabytes a second. But the problem is that speed rating is not compatible with Mac. For whatever reason, the way Apple Silicon works, it will not support those faster speeds. So they'll run at the same exact speed as their slower USB 3 counterparts. So if you get something like the Crucial X10 Pro or the Samsung T9, they're the exact same speed as the Crucial X9 Pro and the Samsung T7. You can get those if you find them at a good deal, but you're not going to get any speed boosts. The next class up is USB 4 and Thunderbolt 3 and Thunderbolt 4 drives. These support speeds all the way up to about 3000 or 3200 megabytes a second, and they're very fast. Most of the drives that come in this speed class are also professional rated drives, so they're going to come with features like aluminum cooling cores, and they're going to be designed to work all day long because they put a specific SSD into the specific enclosure and controller, and they're a little bit more rugged than some of the ones that you can build on your own. I really like the SanDisk Professional Pro G40 and the Oyen U34 Bolt. These are both very fast, but the Oyen is a little faster than the Pro G40, but the Pro G40 is slimmer and feels a little more rugged. The SanDisk you can get from 1, 2, or 4 terabytes, but the Oyen you can get all the way up to 8 terabytes, which is amazing to have 8 terabytes of storage in an external enclosure like this. So I really love both of these drives. I use the Oyen as my main daily editing drive because it's fast and works well even running it all day long. The next speed class is Thunderbolt 5 and USB 4 V2. These support speeds all the way up to about 6,000 megabytes a second, and it's just insane how fast these drives are. These are drives like the OWC Envoy Ultra. Now, I haven't gotten to test that one out yet. I've heard it's great, but the main issue it has is the cable is built in, so if there's ever any issue with the cable, then you're kind of just out of luck with that drive. I do have the Acasis TB501 Pro enclosure, and I'm hitting speeds of about 6,000 megabytes a second on the write side and about 5,500 on the read side. Just note to get those Thunderbolt 5 speeds, you're going to need a computer that has the M4 Pro or the M4 Max chip. So that's the Mac Mini M4 Pro, the Mac Studio M4, or also the new M4 Max or M4 Pro MacBook Pro. Any other computer is just going to default to the fastest possible speed that the computer supports. So if we're talking about SSD enclosures, I've had great luck with these by Acasis. I've also got this Satechi USB 4 enclosure I really recommend. This is the one I typically use when I want an external SSD enclosure. And to set one of these up, all you have to do is get yourself an NVMe and you just insert it at an angle like this and you move the little rubber stopper out of the way. And now you've got this SSD. If you want, you can also always swap the NVMe out if you ever want to get a bigger or smaller one, or you can use multiple NVMEs with one enclosure if you want to. Sometimes you can save money by going with an enclosure and an NVMe, but they're really just a little bit cheaper than buying a pre-built one. The main reason I recommend a pre-built over something like the Satechi or the Acasis enclosures is because these companies can't test every single NVMe with their enclosure and ensure top possible performance. So if you need the top possible performance, that's when I really recommend a pre-built, especially one like the SanDisk Professional or the Oyen U34 Bolt, because those are just top-of-the-line drives. Now that we've talked about all these drives and enclosures, which one should you buy? The first thing you need to ask yourself is what capacity do you need? Do you need 1, 2, or 4 terabytes? If you're doing a lot of video work, that's when I really recommend getting a 4 terabyte. If you're doing some video work and a lot of photos, that's when the 2 terabytes is going to come in handy. Or if you're doing a lot of music production, that's when 2 terabytes or 4 terabytes is going to be a great option as well. If you're just getting into the world of SSDs and you need a way to expand your Mac storage, 1 terabyte would be a great starting option. But for most users, I recommend getting 2 terabytes just so you have the extra storage space. Then once you've decided your capacity, decide what speed class you want. If you just need something to offload files to at pretty fast speeds, if you're doing light to moderate editing on it, that's when something like the Crucial X9 Pro or the Samsung T7 are going to be perfectly fine options for you. They're plenty fast for most day-to-day use. If you're doing heavy editing and you need sustained performance, that's when I really recommend the SanDisk Professional Pro G40 or the Oyen U34 Bolt to get very fast speeds and very great sustained workload. If you need the fastest possible speeds, that's when you could get the OWC Envoy Ultra, but for most users, you're really not going to need those Thunderbolt 5 speeds, and it's only compatible with a select number of computers. If you want to build out your own drive, you could always get the Satechi USB 4 or the Acasis Thunderbolt 3 or Thunderbolt 4 drive. Or if you want to build out the fastest possible drive, that's when I recommend the Acasis TB501 enclosure instead. If you're interested in buying any of these, I have links to buy them all in the description below. If you got any other questions, leave a comment down below. I'll do my best to answer them. Like this video, subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on any upcoming content.